Can you tell us a little bit about the story of the film and why it mattered so much to you to bring it to screen?
So as you know, I've been in lots of blockbuster movies playing horrible villains, and often I nod off at the premieres because I love it, but it kind of goes over my head. I like making human interest stories, and this is a true story, or based on a true story, of a gentleman that sadly left us now called Paul. Paul Thomas, his name, played by Daniel P. Lewis, and his young sister, who ultimately went on to play for Liverpool's ladies football team. So it's a real story of success over extreme adversity. You would never expect people, you know, from very poor place in Liverpool to go as far as they did. And, you know, that's what means so much to me, is when people really, against all the odds, pull through. And those stories really do win hearts and minds. They make you cry, they make you laugh, they make you smile. So that's what it's about, success over extreme adversity. Well, Laura, who when I shot it was only 12, her real name Poppy J. Hughes, we saw 250 tapes. And when I met this girl, I saw this girl on screen, I knew it had to be her. Daniel P. Lewis, bless him, is not only playing a guy with extremely disabled with cerebral palsy, he was producing the movie, and he wrote it, and this guy was switching from making sure that everybody had their lunch into playing someone so severely disabled. And for a man to be able to bring that performance to the screen with all of those challenges, was nothing short of incredible. So both Daniel and Poppy, but the rest of the cast, we've got Leanne Best, a huge star on a lot of the big TV shows. Ricky Tomlinson, who sadly can't be here because, bless him, he's 83 now, and he's like, it's a long way to come. We've got John McCardle, Brookside fame, Coronation Street, big star, Connor McIntyre. So we've got an amazing cast, and it's of all British household names brought together to make this wonderful dramatic piece, you know.
The global interest in women's football has been exploding. Can you talk a little bit about the challenges of bringing that particular industry to life on screen for us?
Well, obviously we didn't have, you know, the full Liverpool football team. We've got the full backing of Liverpool football team. We've got the full backing of Tranmere Rovers totally behind us. So it's amazing. It's weird because you saw ladies football 5-6 years ago, everyone goes, they can't play football. And now they're packing Wembley Stadium. So it's an amazing, you know, breakthrough. And, you know, I think the ladies Liverpool team will give the men's team a run for their money. It's amazing how the world has changed and how ladies football has prospered. So that's been an amazing journey. And also to get the backing of Liverpool's ladies football team is an amazing endorsement. In fact, tonight we've got Mark Pelios is here. I don't know if you've met him. He was the chairman of the FA, and he's now the owner of Tranmere Rovers. If you get a chance to interview him, that would be a good one.
Can you talk about what this festival means for you, and particularly having your film platformed here?
Well, Raindance champion independent film, but they are now becoming, they probably are the biggest independent film festival in the UK, fast becoming the biggest independent film festival in Europe. And, you know, they really do champion independent film. And they've been going for so long now that we're now competing with the BAFTAs and the Oscars. And it's just as important. Independent filmmaking is not easy to do. We're not a big studio with millions of pounds behind us. We're small independent filmmakers, and these guys are the champion of that. And that's why I love them.
Just finally, what does it mean for you to be a director? I mean, obviously, you've been on our screens being murdered 87 odd times. What does it mean for you now to be in the director's chair controlling the story?
It's very hard. I thought it would be easier. I thought I'd be able to sit down and say action and cut. It's not like that. It's very, very difficult. I feel in some ways it's a higher calling to bring these stories to the big screen. I get my bus pass next year. I'm 60 next year, so I've been doing it a long time. You know, you can only be a villain so many times, although I've got 7 more villains booked, so I don't want to upset anybody. But it's, you know, it's more important work for me than playing an imaginary movie villain. I'm telling real stories about real people, and that's what really matters for me in this stage of my career.